Hello and welcome. My name is Matou, Amar, and I am here to explain to you on why you should read Jean Toomer. Now, without further ado, let's begin.
But watching this video, you're probably asking, what makes Jean Toomer so important? The answer can be found by diving deeper into some of his works, especially his most famous work, Cain. Many critics identify Cain as one of the first and most important works of the Harlem Renaissance. It vividly depicts the life of African Americans in both the rural South and urban North during the early 20th century. The conclusion of the work is a prose piece entitled Camis. Stemmed and frustrated by a community that is smothered in inherited assumptions about what defines blackness, Camis revolts. One could argue that Toomer's point for the conclusion prose was to bring up the fact that Camis could not write what he wanted due to the possible backlash he was going to receive from being seen as a stereotypical black writer. One of Toomer's other best-known works during this time was his long lyrical poem, Blue Meridian, which pointedly captured his hopes and dreams for racial unity. As a child, since he was of black and white heritage, Toomer attended all white and all black schools. In the poem, he states, "I did not wish to rise above or move beyond my race. I wished to contemplate who I was beyond my body, this container of flesh." Toomer's recurring argument of the insignificance of the institution of race in one's life is in a different way. He figured blackness as a perpetual becoming, something that simply is. Finally, another piece of Toomer's is his poem, The First American. For the synopsis of the poem, Toomer describes it as such. "I wrote a poem called The First American, the idea which was that here in America, we are in the process of forming a new race, that I was one of the first conscious members of this race. I had seen the divisions, the separatisms, and the antagonisms, yet a new type of man was arising in this country, and in this American, I saw the divisions mended, the differences reconciled, saw that we would be a united people existing in the United States, and saw that we would, in truth, be once again members of a united human race." Toomer references the future he sees, where people in America are simply seen as American, race not being at the forefront. After all of this, your next question may be, what does all of this even mean? How does this relate to society today? To understand the meaning and relevance of Toomer's vision in today's society, we must examine the persistent divisions and differences that continue to exist, particularly in the realm of race and identity. These poems serve as a very powerful reminder that racial inequality and tension that we see today is nothing new. That, if anything, it is the single most persistent and painful issue in the United States history, even if the way some people think about race has changed over time. Despite progress being made in civil rights movements, systemic racism and prejudice still pervade many aspects of daily life.
In some places, especially in the South, people go out of their way to make sure that the race issue remains. This perpetuates social inequality and hinders the attainment of the united future that Toomer envisioned. Essentially, racism is a hindrance to equality and unity. For example, the Confederate flag remains popular among white supremacists and Southerners who claim it as their heritage. In actuality, there is no heritage in that flag's history, and they only argue that claim with the word heritage, as they thought it would be a more suitable or acceptable word for what that flag truly supports, racism. Because of racial inequality, one could argue that's the reason why racial stereotyping is a problem today, perpetuating harmful biases, fostering prejudice, and telling one what a particular race is good at, and that's all that race could be. This perpetuation of racial stereotypes not only limits individual opportunities and potential, but also contributes to the perpetuation of systemic racism and discrimination, further entrenching power imbalances in society. To further support Toomer's argument, check out this clip from the TV show Sonic Boom, where Knuckles explains to Amy on why her comment actually undermines what she's claiming to prove.
"Comes down to the this one penalty kick. Can the young woman break the glass ceiling and prove once and for all that a female can be just as good an athlete as a male?
You know, Amy, anytime someone calls attention to the breaking of gender roles, it ultimately undermines the concept of gender equality by implying that this is an exception and not the status quo.
If one structures Knuckles' quote made in this video to Gene Toomer's argument, it would read, "Anytime someone calls attention to the breaking of racial barriers, it ultimately undermines the concept of racial equality by implying that this is an exception and not the status quo," which challenges the notion that highlighting the breaking of racial barriers unintentionally reinforces the idea that racism is ingrained in our society. Following this quote, when the news portrayed Obama as the first black president in 2008, for example, it backhandedly stated that black people could never become a president because that's not a part of their stereotypical job options, and thus Obama was an exception to the rule. It reinforced the existing racial bias by emphasizing that Obama's achievement was extraordinary, rather than emphasizing the fact that anyone, regardless of race, can aspire to become president. Some believe that Toomer's argument stemmed from the fact that he was mixed, and during his time, mixed children were seen as wretches and were bullied. For Toomer, his skin color did not fully fit in with the black or white community. While this is true, it still does not question the validity of his argument in society today. In conclusion, Gene Toomer's point shown throughout his works is that through the intentional or unintentional perpetuation of stereotypes and biases, society limits the opportunities and potential of marginalized groups. He argues that to aspire to unity in America, there must be a day when stereotypes of a specific race do not conflict or suppress one's individual desires just because it does not follow the stereotypical job. If the majority of Americans could follow Toomer's ideology concerning race in today's society, we could be on track to actually become the United States of America, specifically the United States that Toomer envisioned. Thank you.